Hi everyone, today we will do legal dictation exercise number 12. You can get the PDF from description box. So ready? Start. After thorough analysis of all relevant and attendant factors, we are of the opinion that none of the grounds on which the High Court has cleared the respondent has any merit. By now, it is well settled that the testimony of a victim in cases of sexual offences is vital, and unless these are compelling reasons which necessitate looking for corroboration of a statement, the courts should find no difficulty to act on the testimony of the victim of a sexual assault alone to convict the accused. No doubt her testimony has to inspire confidence. Seeking corroboration to a statement before relying upon the same as a rule in such cases would literally amount to adding insult to injury. The deposition of the prosecutrix has thus to be taken as a whole. Needless to reiterate that the victim of rape is not an accomplice and her evidence can be acted upon without corroboration. She stands at a higher pedestal than an injured witness does. If the court finds it difficult to accept her version, it may seek corroboration from some evidence which lend assurance to her version. To insist on corroboration except in the rarest of rare cases is to equate one who is a victim of the lust of another with an accomplice to a crime and thereby insult womanhood. It would be adding insult to injury to tell a woman that her claim of rape will not be believed unless it is corroborated in material particulars, as in the case of an accomplice to a crime. Why should the evidence of the girl or the woman who complains the rape or sexual molestation be viewed with the aid of spectacles fitted with lenses without disbelief or suspicion? The plea about lack of corroboration has no substance. Notwithstanding this legal position, in the instant case, we even find enough corroborative material as well, which is discussed here in above. From the evaluation of the prosecution material above, it is abundantly clear that the evidence brought on record contains positive proof, credible sequence of events, and factual truth of linking the respondent with rape of the prosecutrix and had criminally intimidated her. Hence, respondent is found to be guilty for offense under section 376 and 596 of IPC, since he committed rape with a minor girl aged 9 years. It is pertinent to point out at this stage that at the time of deposition of the prosecutrix in the court, the trial court had an opportunity to see her demeanor. The statement of the prosecutrix inspires confidence even though a child witness, since while deposing in the court, her demeanor appeared like that of competent witness and no likelihood of tutor. I find her testimony reliable since she was found competent to depose after preliminary inquiry, as she understood questions and to give rational answers. I have gone through her statement with extra caution and full of circumspection. Therefore, I have no hesitation to believe her statement. Thank you.